coming.
If you're anything like me, at this stage you'll be thinking, what on earth is going on?
Do you think you hit it? No. There he is. There he goes.
Bah.
I can't believe that.
Well, that'll take gonna take some time to do. Mustn't lose these bits. Well, I guess that's the biggest botch up that you've ever seen, probably. I can't believe it. Firstly, I'm having a little bit of trouble pulling the bow in the first place, but I seem to have a knock that wasn't staying on the string and kind of coming off at the critical moment, and then gradually, or not even gradually, quickly I think, the panic set in, and that's probably one of the best examples of panic you'd ever see. Here was this beautiful stag, nice bow range, and I just got everything wrong. The last time I shot at a stag with a bow was, would have been 35 years ago, almost to the, not necessarily to the day, but to the week probably. And that was on Stewart Island, and it was a big stag, and I missed that one as well. Well, actually, yeah, I missed that one as well. And, well, that's a classic example of what can happen. Stag fever and absolute utter panic. So the stag, I just cannot believe how he stood around waiting for something to happen. Nothing touched him. Or in all my hunting days, I don't think I've ever seen a deer stand around so long, watching all this commotion going on, and seemingly almost quite unconcerned about it all.
We try not to get too depressed. After all, it's a beautiful day, and it's always a pleasure just to see a stag anyway.
After our last fiasco, we decided to carry on after all and give it another shot. And although things were fairly quiet, we did hear a moan up over in the next gully there, so we're going to try and coax him out and see how we get on.
Can you believe me? I can't believe myself. Well, after that last botch up, we did carry on after all. We decided the day was so beautiful and the hour wasn't all that late. We decided to carry on. And what's happened now is we've had another even worse disaster. We had a beautiful stag come up extraordinarily close, a shot that would have been impossible to miss, and we didn't get him. The only good thing that's come out of it is that we know why I had all that trouble with the first stag, and then why I've lost this stag that would have been a real trophy. In fact, he's a really good stag, one that you don't find very often in this part of the country. What actually did happen, and with my inexperience with a bow, I didn't realise something like I didn't expect it to happen, because it never did while I was practising. But what's happened is that when I've drawn the arrow back, I pulled it right back, and it's hit the bottom of the guard. It's because this blade is upright, vertical, whereas other ones have been, I don't know actually what's happened anyway, but it's caught there and it's pulled the arrow out of the knock out of the string. And of course the arrow just is no longer knocked, and that's what happened. What's happened is that when this bow was set up, it's been set up extraordinarily badly. This bow guard, the bottom of it, is far too low, so it's far too close to the arrow, and you've got all this height here, which is useless height, and not much here. The sight could have been, it's just, I don't really know, it's so badly set up or something. It's cost us a very good trophy, and that's all there is to it, simple as that.
Later back at camp, Dad started making necessary adjustments, and hopefully given another opportunity, things might turn out a lot better.
I think it'll be a mistake if we actually stay properly low. I think we'd better try and have him on the,
on
and
the
then
side.
We've got more options. We'd either then, go slightly low or slightly higher. But if we... just right below him, we've got no options, have we?
No.
Except go up.
Yeah, that's right, you're right, yeah.
On the motor.
We were hoping the stag would come straight up towards father, but next thing I saw him appear over to my right. He was heading straight towards where we'd just come through, and I knew he would hit our scent, but there was nothing I could do. I was surprised when he stopped just below. Dad didn't waste any time picking up on the situation and took immediate action.
Sounded really good. Thump.
I heard a thump.
Sounded like he took off immediately.
Can you see still? Here's the arrow. She's covered in blood, right through. Blood in the tip and everywhere. So hopefully it's been sticking out the other side and stepped as he ran.
Bloody hard to find. You'll be at this time of the flaming night.
Blood all there. It's blood just all bloody.
Okay, let's go find him.
We're back again after last night. We tossed it in last night, got a bit dark and a bit ugly, so we went back down. And we've come back up this morning and we found that we thought he'd run straight down to the creek and give it up down there, but no, he ran down a little bit to start with, and he's sidled around here and came up a little bit, which is pretty surprising.
Yeah, you almost always expect a wounded beast to run downhill, but yeah. It did surprise us what happened.
And there wasn't much blood either, which is another thing, so you've got to be careful. Just because they've got a solid hit doesn't always mean there's going to be a good blood trail, you know? Mm. So.
That can apply whether you're bow hunting or rifle shooting. There isn't always a lot of blood, is there?
No. No. Often there is, but don't sort of count on it. Mm. Just because there isn't, don't give up.
That's the point of it, isn't it?
Yeah.
But we've got a pleasant surprise over the rise here. Now, isn't that a great sight for any hunter, more particularly a bow hunter? And when it's your first deer with a bow, woohoo!
Looks like a good shot too. It's come right through here. He's exited here. And he should have gone in behind the shoulder, did it?
Yucky-mucky, doesn't it?
It's gone right through. It's gone clean through.
Whacky-doo.
It's a super little head if it was a rooster or something. It's a nice little rooster head. Yeah,
it's exactly as he fell, just like that, eh?
He's a bit stiff because it's had a little bit of time to rest overnight. Yeah, it's come out right here.
I reckon that's amazing, isn't it?
It's amazing that there's not more blood all the way along, but I don't know.
Yeah, people can get him over. Well, that was a perfect shot, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It's a huge relief to get this beast after all my botch-ups before, like dropping arrows off the string and... You know, and arrows off the rest and things like that. Having trouble pulling the bow.
Yeah.
The old 68-year-old muscles and things are not working so well these days. So. Yeah.
Wasn't that well set up, I don't think, the bow.
No, actually, so all that work on it, like tuning it a bit more and winding the poundage down a little helped, I think.
It's not about just picking up a bow and going bow hunting. There's a lot of fine tuning to be done before you can even attempt to go out, really, to be fair. Yeah,
sure is, yeah. But I think congratulations in order, aren't they?
Thanks very much.
Yeah, that was very terrific.
Good on you. All right, viewers, let's go.
It was a good team, yeah.